Hello, everybody. Welcome to one of our webinars in our series of webinars at Automatrix. Today, the topic is fitting. So, get started with fitting verification using a simplified workflow, as much as we can simplify in a half an hour webinar. A little bit of tips and tricks. First of all, I'm both the presenter and the moderator. My name is Mariana Rosling Jensen. I'm Education and Training Manager at Automatrix. And a little bit of housekeeping. So all participants are mute for reduced background noise. It's possible to ask questions during the session. You have a question box on the right side of your screen, and you can write there your question. I will collect the questions during the session, and I will answer that as much as I can at the end of the session. In case I have some unanswered questions, I will reply to you in an email after the webinar. So let's get started. I always think about why is verification under utilized. And then I went around and asked people and look at different articles. And the reason why the biggest reason for people not doing verification is it takes too long. So it requires a little bit more time in the fitting process with the patient. The probe tube placement, it's a big concern, both in confidence and accuracy. Sometimes when I'm visiting customers, I ask what are the biggest wishes they have, and they would say that they were sure that the probe were placed correctly, so they knew that the measurements they were doing were as good as possible. Another reason is the complexity of the measurements and manual adjustments needed during with the fitting instrument. So the process in between you do your measurements, and then afterwards you have to go in and adjust so you fit it to target. The mismatch between generic prescriptive targets and proprietary algorithms. So how do I know what's best for my patient? Is it the fitting targets from the manufacturers, or should I use prescriptive targets like NAHL and DSL? People are confused about that. And additional professional time requiring for learning, training, and practice. So I read that as people perhaps are insecure that they are doing the right thing. They don't know exactly how to do. So I will try to, in this webinar, I will try to pick up on these topics and then talk about them. So I would like also to look at the user experience. So if we go and ask users, hearing aid users, what would make them keep the hearing aid? They think that audiologists, they use a very complex language, and this may present a barrier for patients to understand the hearing rehabilitation recommendations. These make people not understand exactly what is going on when they are having a fitting. Why? What should I expect for a fitting? What should I expect for my hearing aid? And because of that, it results that patients are less willing to try the hearing aids because they don't really understand what is it the hearing aid can give them, what is that they are missing. And it has been proved by this research that clear, concise language is recommended because it's going to facilitate the decision of the user and also make them understand exactly what do they should expect for hearing aid. So I think the fitting process and the use of verification is to understand which kind of gain we are giving to the patient, which kind of expectations they should have for that, and for us to understand exactly what is that the hearing aid is doing for this patient. So let's pick up on these five topics that we were talking about. So smart way to work, it's doing verification. It has been proven, right? patients get more satisfied if we involve them. They will accept that they need what they need, and we can be sure that we are delivering what they need or as much as what they need as we can give and they can accept. People say they are worried that it takes time, but in reality, if we think about it, it saves time because we understand exactly what we are doing, and in that way, it's going to save time for us. So we want to do our customers more satisfied, and we want them to perceive us as professional as possible. Good. Let's look what is the definition of verification. It's measurements that determine what the hearing aid, if the hearing aid are meeting a particular standard, or exactly what is the hearing aid delivered at the eardrum. And I think that's a common misunderstanding because we think verification is exactly the same as meeting target. And actually, verification is, for me, it's not the same as meeting target, but verification is understanding what is that we are giving the patient, right? This is the verification, so we understand how much gain we are giving them, and the validation actually is to prove how much are they using of what we are giving to them. So again, we have to meet targets, that's what we want, and then we have to realize how much these people can use of this target. Sometimes they can't use exactly all everything. So let's talk a little bit about that. So if we look at the reasons that I put in the beginning of the presentation, additional time to required for feeding process. And I already said that I think actually, we save time when we are doing verification, right? So what is that we need to do? If we do in a very simplified way, we need to measure the unaided response and we needed to measure an aided response, right? That's what we have to do, nothing else than that. And perhaps a little bit more than that, because we need to do the aided response, but we need to find out what is that our customer, our client need. We have to understand that all our customers don't have the same needs. So that's why I say meeting the target. What is meeting the target? It's meeting the target for this patient, right? So if we look at the 10 steps, I try to determine 10 steps so it makes very simplify exactly what do we need to do. So first of all, we need to program the hearing aid. We need to program the hearing aid if we are using a verification or not, right? And then we need to choose a protocol. And when I say choose a protocol, it's more than we have to find out what our goal, what is the rationale that we are going to use for this exactly feeding. You can use the rationale, the now or detail. You can perhaps also, if you prefer to use the targets from the hearing aid manufacturers, today you can actually do that as well. And then you need to do a probe calibration. And this is the first step that you really need to do on the top of a normal feeding, right? Because the decision of the programming the hearing aid, the decision of the rationale, you will have to do anyway. And then insert the probe tube, and that's the part that people are a little bit afraid. We have already heard about that. And then we have to measure the real ear unaided response. Right? And both these two, insert the probe tube and measure the real ear unaided response together, they are going to give us the safety that we are doing a good job by placing the probe. We are going to look at that in our next slide. Then we have to insert the hearing instrument to the ear, select the feeding details. What is the feeding details? The feeding details is going to be which rationale we are using, which kind of style of the hearing aid we are using. Are we using open feet? Is our open feet really open? Things like that. We have to select all the details for the feeding that might change our target, right? And then we measure the real ear aided response. We will have to adjust the hearing instrument, first of all, to fit to the target, right? We need to be sure this hearing aid that we have chosen for this patient is a hearing aid that can deliver the gain, that the optimal gain, because we know that the optimal gain will be fitting the target. And then we were going to adjust to expected level for your patient. And for that, we need to understand the target. And we need to understand as well the need that this patient has. If we think about two different people, we have a very active person, right, that works and travel around, or go to meetings, go to different sound environments. This person, probably to understand everything, they need everything that that we need to meet the target and give as much as possible, as close as possible to the target. But if we think about another person, where the most important environment to her, let's say an elderly person that like to play cards and watch television, does she have the same needs as the person that works and go active and change environments? Probably not. So we need to know that the hearing aid is able to achieve the target, but perhaps the entire gain is too much for this person, and this person will have too much uncomfortable of having the hearing aid. It will be bigger than matching the target. So we need to understand what is that we want when we are matching the target, and we need to understand the fitting. It's not the same using verification. It's not the same as matching the target. But using verification is understanding how much we are giving. And when we understand, we can help our client to understand what are the expectations they should have for the hearing aid. Let's look about the reason that people are not using verification. That's the probe tube placement, right? That was where people were afraid that, were they doing a good job? So if we look, and I told you when I was going through the 10 steps, that the rear ear unaided response is going to actually tell us when we are doing this measurement, we can actually see if we are matching, if we have put the probe as close as possible to the eardrum. And that's the bigger thing, we need to put as close as possible to the eardrum, because that's the sound pressure level that we want to measure, right? And if we look at this curve, at the left side, you can see that here it's pretty good because it's up on the top of the zero line. If this line at around 6,000 hertz start going down, then you can be sure that you are not as close as possible to the eardrum as you should do, and then you should be unsafe. But if you know that, then you can be sure. You can ensure by placing the probe as close as possible to the eardrum, right? So let's look at how do we do that. So one of my colleagues make this video that I think it's a very good video to show how do we know that we are placing the probe. So we place the probe, we do the real ear unaided response, we can see that it's too low, and then we can slowly put closer and closer to the eardrum, and in that way we can see that the line is gonna start moving upwards, and then we are sure that we are not touching the eardrum of the patient, but we ensure that we have placed the probe at the right place, right? If you're afraid to do that, we have in our system now what we call a probe tube assistant. Probe tube assistant will assist you in place the probe in the right place. So what you have to do is actually place the probe at the ear of the patient, and then the system will start measuring, and the system will show you, let me go back, that now you are 8 millimeters from the eardrum. You keep on putting into the ear, and then until you get it right. In that way, there is no way you are not going to be right placing the probe. And this might sound stupid, but a lot of people have problems, and a lot of the places I have been visiting, there was the only reason for them not to measuring. So the probe tube assistant, or using the zero line when you are measuring the open ear, you will be able to see if you are putting the probe in the right place, and reassure yourself that you are doing a good job. So no reason to be insecure about if you are doing a good job or not. So the other reason was complexity of measurement and manual adjustment needed to do for the hearing aids instrument gains. I try to put an example here where I measure the hearing aid, and here you can see what you are seeing in this line is the dotted line that you are seeing here. That's the line where we can see that's our target, right? The other line here, the other purple line here, this is the line that this is what we measure. And if you look a bit underneath, that's what we call the on target. And here you can see how much you need to adjust the hearing aid to match your target. That way, we can help you how much adjustment this hearing aid needed. You can also use what we call on top mode, so you can see both screening. You can see the screen of your hearing aid fitting here, and you can see the software. So at the same time as you are measuring, you can see exactly what is going on in the fitting and how much you need to adjust. That way, it is really easy to visualize how much you need to adjust and how do you do to get to the target, right? And you have both softwares that you can work together. Let's see in practice, how does this look like? So I'm gonna go a little bit further just to show you. So I do my measurement, and here you can see we are a little bit far from what we call the target over here that you can see in the dotted line. And then we need to adjust. Here you can see on target how much you needed to adjust. And then you can have both screening together in on the top mode. And then you can see you need to adjust here. Then you can go down under here and then adjust exactly in the frequencies. And you can use the on target to tell you exactly how much do you need to adjust in the frequency, right? So you go and change your gain of the hearing aid, adjust how much, and then you can measure one more time to be sure that you are doing a good job. And then again, you are gonna measure one more time and see if now you have matched the target. You can see now we are closer. We are still missing a little bit around here. So let's adjust one more time, and then we can measure one more time until we are satisfied. Remember, we have to get plus minus 5 dB. So doesn't need to be exactly, but as close as possible. But now you can see you are really close, and it took us, 2 minutes to do that. And when you get a little bit of practice, then you can even do faster than that. Okay, let's go to, if you think this is still a little bit too cumbersome, you can use the automated target basic fitting. This is integrated software. As I don't know if you have been to our webinar for 2 months ago, where we talk about the target match that we have with now. The target match is with Phonak, but we have now with different manufacturers that you can streamline your fitting and verification. So you use only by using only one software. Only the software of the manufacturer, you can make the adjustments will happen automatically. Then you can also choose your target. So remember, when you are doing a fitting, always remember to choose which targets do you want. Do you want to use the hearing aid manufacturers? Because that's what you are used to, and that's what you think your customers are happy with. Or do you want to try something else, another DSL? Because for you, the most important is the speech understanding, right? And these are the targets that are proven that are giving your customer the best speech understanding. Okay. the mismatch between the generic prescriptive targets and the algorithm and the proprietary algorithm. That's a little bit what I was talking about. How do I decide which target do I want to use? How do I can I make this decision? I think we have to think, like I said before, if we are talking about the hearing aid manufacturers, they have their own targets. They have their own way of how do we the hearing aid users can get used to the hearing aid. They have done their tests. And then we have the Noul and DSL that are proven giving the best speech understanding for our patients. Both are very good targets. And if we look at the targets from the hearing aid manufacturers, they are closer and closer to the Noul. It's an adaptation of the Noul, most of them, to their algorithms in the hearing aid. But as I understand, say, we have also to understand our user. So we have to understand what is that the target needs, what is that we want, is it fitting to target? I think more and more we get the understanding that we need to understand our customer. And when we do the fitting, it's understanding the hearing aid, and we have to put those two things together. So the questions I can put to you now is, fitting to target, is that verification? I think actually it's more than that. And that's why I put the expectations of the clients as one of the topics in the webinar as well. Because what does it mean to map the target? What are your targets? Your targets in reality is make your client satisfied, right? So you, again, you ensure that you can map the target, but perhaps in parallel, you need to reduce a little bit, because that person that was at home and need to watch television and play cards doesn't have the same need as the person that are very active. And perhaps the target is not matching the target, but matching the target will give you the balance in between the high frequencies and the low frequencies. And perhaps you need to reduce a little bit of the gain. And if you explain your customer that that's what you are doing, you are doing a balance in between the speech intelligibility and the comfort. And that's the balance that we need to meet with all our clients, right? We need to meet a good speech intelligibility and a good comfort. For some people, the speech intelligibility, it's the main focus. For other people, the comfort is more, it's more important, right? So, if we have another tool that I think is a very, very good tool also for us to understand what is the hearing loss, what is the dynamic range of the patient, and how does the speech banana look like for a person with this exactly hearing loss. So if you look at here, this, I have a person with a hearing loss and I have a normal speech banana here. What we see here is the dynamic range. So we don't want to go up here. We have to go over this one because that's where we are amplified. If we choose to see the customized speech banana, now you can see that speech banana that was here, now the speech banana is up here. And that's where we have to get the gain of the hearing aid to be sure that the person can hear everything of the sound, of the speech sound. So again, I think for each fitting, we have to look at where is our target? When we met our target, what is that the person is getting out of it? And if we think about this target here, we are matching pretty much the target. But if we go over 4,000 hertz, we are not on target. Why are we not there? Why can't we? Perhaps because the person thinks that's too uncomfortable. But we have an SII of 81%. That's pretty good. So do we need to try to fit the hearing aid over to get to the target if this person is satisfied? No, but now I understand what exactly am I doing and how much of the speech this person with this hearing loss, with this exactly fitting that I'm doing, is getting out of the fitting that I'm doing for them. So additional professional time requiring for learning, training, and practice, yes, this is a reality. We need to really get to know what we are doing, and we need to understand how much gain we are giving on the hearing aid, how much this hearing aid that we have chosen have delivered to this patient. And do we need to deliver everything? We need to start thinking that the verification and matching to targets is exactly the same. So if we follow the 10 steps that I show you, and even though you think it, perhaps you think the 10 steps is still too complicated, then you can still use the automatic fitting for the different manufacturers that now is available in many of the manufacturers. So I think that's what I have to tell you today in this short half an hour that we had. Let me see if there is any questions, please. If you have any question, write into the box. I can see there is some questions. Give me 2 seconds if I can. The question is, I'm sorry, I understand the real ear aided response is for the first time without the opinion of the patient. So do you think do this only one time, the first time the patient put on the hearing aid? Now, I think what I was trying to explain is we are going to fit to target as good as possible, right? And then perhaps the comfort for the, let's say the comfort for this patient is the most important. Then I will adjust it down to the comfort of the patient. I will adjust everything in parallel, because then I know I have the balancing in between the gain of the bass and the high frequency. I know I have a good balance, so I will reduce. And then I will verify again. And normally I will also show my patient, because I want to involve my patient on that, right? I will show them how much I have reduced, and then I will send them home. And in the next visit, they will come. We are going to talk about that. I needed to reduce the gain because that was too much for you. So do you want now me to increase a little bit? How it's going? Did you got used to it? We know that people need to get used to the gain. So all these things have to take into account. And I think if you use the verification as a tool to talk to your client about the expectations of the hearing aid, how much the hearing aid is delivering. And if we look at this slide here, in that fitting, we had a very good fitting and we could match the target. But if we had a severe to profound hearing loss, perhaps we couldn't match the target. And then we are going to explain then, look, I couldn't match, the hearing aid is not powerful enough, or this they have a very high frequency loss and you are not able to match everything. This is a good tool to explain them what they should expect, because you know if you are not getting all the high frequencies or if you are getting all the low frequencies, then you can explain them, look, you are not getting everything out of the speech signal, but that's what I can do. Or if the client comes to you and say, this is too, it's too sharp, the sound, and you need to take some of the high frequencies. You can again show them, look, I'm taking the high frequencies out. That means that some of the sound that should be into the gain is not going to be there. Okay, I hope I answered the question. So I will say thank you for your participation today. Please keep, there will be upcoming seminars, webinars, and the program for the next year will be available in December. Thank you for your participation today, and I see you in December in our next webinar. Bye, thank you.